Okay, so we're back to another video. This is the 3D Mark slingshot test, and we're going to try and both devices. Okay, so let's. And 3, 2, 1. So they will be running in parallel at the same time.
When life breaks down, when there is systemic contradiction, my name symbolized all that was corrupt to society. His name symbolized all that was pure, and I was being held in the embrace of a man who was pure. And these inviolable sanctities were preserved in those 10 words. And it is the desacralization of all of these that has put us in the mess that we find ourselves. Isn't it true? Alas, it is much worse. A person may end up believing in anything. Himself puts his arms around you and says, "Welcome home."
Okay, so the iPhone SE 2 has a bit of an advantage. Let's see how it goes. So the FPS seems to be a bit more than double on the SE 2, while the SE has around 300 or 600 FPS.
My name symbolized all that was corrupt to society. His name symbolized all that was pure. And I was being held in the embrace of a man who was pure.
So we can see the FPS, it's roughly double on the SE2. Of course, this was expected because of the faster GPU inside. And we got the result on the SE2, 4034. And it will finish soon on the SE1. So here is the result. Let's see how it finishes on the SE. Yeah, so it finished also on the SE, and as you can see, the difference is roughly double. So from the old SE to the new. Okay, so we're going to run the iStorm benchmark on each device. Let's open. Okay, so we have this in 3, 2, 1. As you can see, the SE2 is already faster. And the FPS seems to be
Very close.
Not much difference in between the two devices. Of course the AC2 it's a bit faster, but let's see the final score.
Of a man who was pure.
So the test is iStorm Unlimited, and we shall see the results. I think there will be a big difference, but the FPS from what I'm seeing, it's roughly similar, just 100 FPS more. So 1400, while the AC2 and the AC1 has 100 less. And after the results, I will measure the temperature to see on each device how hot does it get during the benchmark. Okay, so yeah, the iPhone SE finished and it's maxed out. Well, this is interesting. So while we don't have the FPS, from what I'm seeing, the results are okay. Let's see. Ah, so here we have the FPS, so it's maxed out. This means it had more than 100 FPS, so yeah, the results are very, very good. So now let's do the test with the temperature sensor. So we have an ambient temperature of 24 degrees almost. Let's see after the results how the temperature is on the back of the device. So we can see the iPhone SE has 31. So it has a hotspot of 31 degrees. And yeah, it's okay. And let's see the SC1, what is the temperature. So let's put this, so you see the SC1 has a bit higher temperatures. So 35 degrees almost. Yeah, so there you got it. Temperatures are, let's say, higher on the SC2. This is to be expected because of the CPU, which has more nanometers. But yeah, that's about it. Thank you for watching.